In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Welcome, my dear brother and sister, to our evening reflection, good night message. This Wednesday, when we thank God for the gift of this day, and that we have come to the close of it, we ask Him to bless us as we take our rest. But before then, my dear brother and sister, we have wronged God in one way or another. Let us call to mind our sins and let us ask for God's pardon, mercy, and strength. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous faults. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us have our reading this evening. A reading from First Letter of St. Peter, Chapter 4, from verse 13 to 14. Dearly beloved, rejoice to the extent that you share in the sufferings of Christ, so that when His glory is revealed, you may also rejoice exultantly. If you are insulted for the name of Christ, blessed are you, for the Spirit of glory and of God rests upon you. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Welcome, my dear brother and sister, to our reflection this evening. And remember, this reading has been prompted by the saints we celebrated today, the martyrs, that is Andrew Dunlack and his companion, Vietnamese, and also some Europeans, around 117 of them who died in Vietnam because of standing firm in their faith. We are told from history that it lasted for around 100 years. And during this time, they were killed and they were tortured. And we are told the kind of torture they went through. People could not bear it. My dear people of God, you know, that has to give us some faith. That has to give us some hope. That has to give us some encouragement. Because many times we go through probably few tortures and all that, or even few challenges in our families, even in our workplace, and also in all that we do. And we tend to give up. Here, there are people who have suffered or who suffered at the period of almost 100 years who are being killed, who are being tortured just because of standing firm by the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Our faith, I believe, people of God, has been tested in various ways. It could be in your family, through your spouse. It could be through our children, with what is happening in our country now. It could be through your business, which is closing down. It could be through even your work, maybe where you are employed. You've received so many warnings and all that. And there are many things, malice and all that happening at workplaces. All those things, people of God, you can take it as like a torture that like Andrew Dunlack and his companions went through. Andrew Dunlack was a priest. The others were missionaries and others were lay people. People of God, it doesn't matter at what state of life you are in, but remember, you just need to be faithful because our God is faithful. You need to be faithful because God Himself has always been faithful to us. So what we do is just to reciprocate that faithfulness to our Lord Jesus Christ. I know when we go through these challenges in life, let the words and also the blood shed by these martyrs be an encouragement to all of us. Because the reading of today is telling us that rejoice to the extent that you share in the sufferings of Christ. Meaning, the footsteps that our Lord Jesus Christ took, it is more or less the same footsteps that we take in our lives because we encounter and go through these sufferings in our Christian calling. What we need to do is let us have that hope. Let us have, that resilience that we don't turn back. We don't need to look back again where we've come from and the challenges we go through. But let our focus still be our Lord Jesus Christ, the one who helps us in our journey of faith. Remember we also that when the glory of Christ is revealed, because we know after these sufferings, Christ sat at the right hand of God the Father, will also be in that part of our Lord Jesus Christ. And that's why when you say, when the saints go marching in, Lord, let me be in that number, because I've also endured sufferings and I've persevered and I've decided to remain firm in my faith to the end. And as we are told by the readings every other day, that those who persevere to the end are the one who will be saved. Let us pray, my dear brother and sister, that through the inspiration of Saint Andrew Dunlac and his companions, we may also have that firm faith in us, that they may pray for us always, especially on the moments that we have wanted to give up, to continue striving hard in our daily lives and especially in our Christian life, that we may win that crown that is promised by each one of us. Remember we also that if you are insulted in the name of Christ, blessed are you, for the Spirit of glory and of God rests in you. So when you are insulted, it's not only by chance that you are insulted, but that glory of God is in you. Let those words be the words of encouragement as we take our rest this Wednesday, that God may bless us, that tomorrow we may rise up, God willing, fresh, strong again in faith, that we may carry out another day. Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit. You have redeemed us, Lord God of truth. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Into your hands, Lord, I commend my spirit. Protect us, Lord, as we stay awake. Watch over us as we sleep, that awake you may keep out with Christ, and asleep, rest in his peace. At last, all-powerful Master, you give leave to your servant to go in peace according to your promise. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared for all nations, the light to enlighten the Gentiles and give glory to Israel, your people. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Protect us, Lord, as we stay awake. Watch over us as we sleep, that awake you may keep watch with Christ, and asleep, rest in his peace. Let us pray. O God, source and origin of all fatherhood, who kept the martyrs St. Andrew Dunlac and companions faithful to the cross of your Son, even to the shedding of their blood, grant through their intercession that, spreading your love among our brothers and sisters, we may be your children in name and in truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you all, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I've been your priest, Father Mika Kibeti Kimboi. Thank you so much, and have a blessed night.